Hello, welcome to the channel of www.talk.works, the online platform for electrification and robotic kits for your farming projects. My name is Alexandre Prévost-Smany, and today I'm going to give you a quick overview of the main steps to build your electric agricultural robot called SRBC. At the end of November 2025, during SITEVI, the international trade fair for vineyard professionals, I was able to demonstrate live in front of visitors that it's possible to build your own robots in less than 2 hours using simple tools and only basic mechanical skills. To introduce the SRBC robot, it's a 200 kilogram multifunctional electric platform. At the rear, it has a 3-point hitch system, so you can attach different implements. Its pulling force is around 100 kiloforce, and it can drive up to 3.5 km per hour. It can also carry loads during harvesting or crop maintenance operations. Its automation system uses RTK-GPS system with centimeter level accuracy. Thanks to this, I can create or record autonomous work missions in the robot's app, and then ask the robot to repeat them very precisely. So now let's start assembling the robot. First, you put together the two tracks unit, install the roller, mount the electric motors, and then fit the robot track. You repeat this operation for the right track and the left track. Once both tracks are assembled, I can place and bolt the main box of the robot, which also serves as a frame of the vehicle. At the front of the chassis, I install the weight box and the anti-collision sensor. Next, I can mount the antenna support at the rear of the robot. The two square antennas receive the RTK-GPS signal, while the other three antennas receive Wi-Fi and 4G signals, so you can control the robot from your smartphone, either on-site or remotely. Then we install the junction box, which contains the robot's onboard computer, as well as a fuse that distributes the electrical power. All cables are fitted with connector designed for agricultural use, and you just need to plug them in. I have to connect all the junction box connectors to the motors, sensors, and to the lift cylinder of the rear linkage. I can also make sure to screw the antenna connector onto the side of the box. Finally, I can install the battery, or two batteries if I have chosen the extended autonomy options. Then we can power up the robot to check that all the actuators are working correctly. Once the checks are complete, I can close the box and finish installing the rear hinge. The robot is now ready to work. I just need to send a mission order, which is basically a path to follow. The path inside the mission order includes the working paths, how the robot makes U-turns, and the geofencing zone, which makes sure the robot always stays inside the safe area to work in. To assemble the robot, I only use standard tools like open-end wrenches, socket wrenches, Allen key, and a pair of pliers. For someone who is used for this type of work, it takes a little bit less than 2 hours. But I advise you to plan half a day of work. That way you can work in the best conditions, read the documentation carefully, and take the time to understand all the technological components of your future robot. I hope you enjoy this video and that you're ready to put the SRBC robot to work on your own farm, whether for crop maintenance, small precision seeding, patrol missions, or helping you carry loads. I am sure you will find many ways to use the robot to help you in your daily work. The SRBC robot is delivered as a kit, so you can get familiar with and take advantage of agricultural robotics technology at a price that is finally accessible. You can find the robot kit directly on the website www.talk.works. The link is in the description below. Subscribe to the channel if you don't want to miss our videos and tutorials on how to use and set up the SRBC robots and our other robots and kits. Goodbye, and see you soon on the TalkWork channel.